In today's practical 3D printing video, we will be going to design a replacement for a broken chain guard for a bike and print it out in AprintaPro's polycarbonate ABS. Guten Tag everyone and welcome to CNC Kitchen! So the chain guard of my girlfriend's bicycle is already broken since quite a while, which was bothering her, since she regularly ruined her trousers with the chain oil. I had already been looking for a replacement, but didn't find a well suitable one. Then I realized, dude, you have a 3D printer, why don't you print a new one? And that's exactly what I'll be showing you. I will walk you in details through the design process in Fusion 360 and then explained why I did use PC-ABS as a printing material. Before I started with the design, I removed the old and broken chain guard from the sprocket but screwed the bolts back in to measure the distance between them. This is the most important interface dimension, which we will later need for a proper design. I will also show you a method how you can use an image in Fusion 360 as a reference. In order to get this reference photo method working properly, we will need to calibrate it with a measured dimension, which will be the distance between the bolt holes. I took a picture as perpendicular as possible of the part to get the least amount of distortion in our reference image. With these things prepared, we will continue in Autodesk Fusion 360. So at first we're gonna insert the image of the chain guard we did outside as a background image in Fusion 360. So just create it on your XY plane. The scale doesn't matter right now, I just make it a little bit bigger that it's easier to see. And now comes the really cool part. So we have measured the dimension between two of the bolts outside, so we know that the distance of these bolts should be 146.6 millimeters, and we can do a calibration on this image. So I zoom in, I select the midpoints of the bolts in the image, and then a small window will pop up where you can insert the dimension, and this will then scale your image automatically to size. So just that it's easier to work with later, I set the opacity to a smaller value so that our design parts shine through. And I'm also moving the image a little bit so that the midpoint of the image is also more or less the midpoint of our part later, or the origin of our coordinate system. And this will just make things much easier later when we design the part. So I created the image with my macro lens, and the macro lens has the nice property that the image distortion is quite small. And this is quite important if you want to sketch such a part. So if you don't have a macro lens, just go a little bit further away from your object you are taking a picture of. This will reduce the distortion a little bit and be then a better baseline for the design later. So now we're gonna start with the design. So we create a new sketch on our XY plane just by clicking on it, and now you can already see why I have moved the image to the middle, so that the two circles we're creating now can be created from the origin of the coordinate system. Next, I just give them a dimension. I just round the numbers up that they're nice. I didn't measure them because it's not important in this case. So we leave the sketcher, we extrude our sketch by 4 millimeters, and we go back again in order to create the second part of the rim. So just a circle again. I round the diameters again. So we select the sketch again, we extrude it. So I actually made a mistake right now, because if you extrude a sketch and this extrusion body will cut an already existing body, it will automatically change the operation to cut, and we don't want to cut the part. We want to join the new bodies, so I just right click on the icon down in the progress bar and edit the feature and change the operation mode from cut to join. And now we can already see that we have this nice L shape which goes around of our part. Okay, so next we will create the lugs which holds our chain guard to our bicycle. So I go into the sketcher, I create this midpoint line right here, center line right here, and this will just will make it easier later to create certain features which are symmetric. So I create a circle in the middle, I just create the two lines right here on the side, I just roughly put them into the proper location. I use the symmetry tool to make these points symmetrical to my construction line, which I did before. And now you can just drag and move everything to see if the symmetry operation is working properly and to just roughly set your dimensions. And then I use the dimension tool again to create real dimensions that nothing moves around later. So what I actually did miss in this step is using the dimension we have measured with our calipers before, so the 146.6 millimeters, to properly dimension the midpoint of, well, the hole in the lug. But I'm gonna do that later, I'll show you that. Okay, so we go out of the sketch, we select the different parts of our sketch, and now just extrude them again. I don't actually use a dimension value at this point. I use the extend to object command. And if your sketch is not intersecting the location you want to extend it to, you would need to change the option you've just seen. So now I create a second sketch on the other side of the part to create the stud, which will then be in contact with our bike. Now just simply select it, use the press pull tool to extrude it a little bit. So what we will be creating next is the stepped hole in the lug, and this stepped hole is for, well, screwing or bolting the part to our bicycle. So what I did actually miss in the first sketch is to create the smallest diameter, diameter where the threads of the bolt will actually go through the part. So I have edited the sketch again, and then at first I extrude the smallest diameter through the whole lug, and since we want to have it stepped, I use the second sketch. So I use the second circle, which is not extruded all the way, so that we have a part where the head of the bolt can lie on. So we create a small fillet at the rim of the stud, that the point of contact to our bike is a little bit smaller and it doesn't wobble around that much. So I turn off the canvas, that just we can see how it's looking at the moment. So as you have seen, we have now just created one of these lugs. We will use a circular pattern to pattern this lug all around of the part. And the nice thing in Fusion is that you can just select the faces which belong to that lug, select as an axis the Z axis of our part, quantity to 4, and hit OK, and we have 4 lugs all around of our part. When we turn on our canvas again, we can directly see that the lugs are now at the proper location. And so we kind of confirmed that the spacing between all of those lugs was like 90 degrees. Okay, perfect. Okay, so next we will create the cutout where the crank arm is. So I just create a new sketch. I create a rectangle at the location where the cutout will be. Just roughly dimension it. Just 40 millimeters, that should be fine. This doesn't need to be perfectly to size. Select it again and use the push tool to create this 6 millimeter cutout. So the remaining section is kind of small, so we want to reinforce that section with a small sketch or with a small part. So I again create a construction line in the middle, which I will be using for my symmetry operations. I sketch the reinforcement, use the symmetry command again on all of the points, that everything is symmetric. So just roughly dimension it so that it's to size properly. So right here I create an angle of 35 degrees, and I'll also dimension the distance between these points right here. So this seems to be a little bit big, so I changed the dimension to 3 millimeters. Looks good. I use the press pull tool again and create another extrusion with the two object commands to extrude everything to the lower side of our chain guard. Nice, so that's actually already more or less it. So the last things we're doing is just to create a couple of fillets to get everything nice. You might notice that the fillet we are doing at the moment, we could have actually already done this in the step when we have created the first lug and then also include that in our pattern operation, but I just kind of forgot that and did this right now. These fillets we are creating right here are not only, that it looks good, they will reduce the notches at these locations so that our part becomes stronger, so that it's not that susceptible when it's getting loaded with higher stresses. And it actually looks kind of perfect. It totally resembles our old part. So we should be at a good point in order to use this as a replacement part for the old broken chain guard we had. So just for aesthetic purposes, I also added a small chamfer around the outer circumference of the part. And as I said before, I actually missed using our really measured dimension of the distance of, the holes of the lug. And I'll do this now. You can always switch back in your history and do these changes. as long as they are not too big and well, change surfaces and stuff like that. So I go into the sketch again. I created this the symmetry line in the middle, and I used actually a dimensional constraint for this because we have been measuring the 146.6 millimeters, and I don't need to well, divide that value in my head. I chose PC-ABS as a printing material for this project. The reason for this is that the part will be exposed to lots of abuse, especially on a hot summer day. PLA, PETG, and even probably ABS would just soften in direct sunlight. Polycarbonate ABS has an even higher softening point and should be more impact resistant as ABS. Also, I really wanted to try out this new material and see how it fares as an engineering grade filament. The Austrian-based company AprintaPro was so nice to provide the material for me to play around with. Printing was not as simple as PLA, and I even built a makeshift printer housing to get the best printing results. I have to admit that I avoided printing ABS as much as possible so far due to the toxic smell. For this reason, I did not have lots or almost only bad experiences with printing this material group, which caused some frustrations with my first prints. AprintaPro has a nice cheat sheet on their website which helped me dialing in the settings, and after some trial and error, the print results were really nice. I printed the chain guard at 260 centigrade with a 100 degree heated bed on glue stick. The smell was kind of similar to ABS, but maybe not as strong. All in all, I was really satisfied with the printing results when I found the proper settings. The material has a nice silky finish and even overhangs printed really nicely. One thing that also impressed me was that supports were really easy to break away, almost as with PLA. I'm currently building an impact testing machine, and as soon as that's finished, I'll post a proper material strength review about PC-ABS. I mounted the chain guard back on the bicycle where it fit perfectly due to the design approach we used. Now my girlfriend is happy again, and you know how it works. If she's happy, I'm happy. What are your thoughts about that small project? What would you have done differently? I hope you learned something for your next project. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it and consider subscribing to the channel that you don't miss any future videos. If you want to support the channel, consider sending me a donation on PayPal or use the affiliate links in the video's description. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and I'll see you next time!